Hi there. Welcome to my production day. I'm going to be drawing a little bit here based on what I started last time. I was actually doing a sketch where I was showing how to kind of work through your ideas. So I have the sketch that I started with in front of me. And I'm looking at it today and I'm kind of like, not really that excited. So I kind of want to show you what I would do normally and just see kind of how I would evolve through this and maybe even just start over. So when I say start over, I'm like, you never know. So I have this picture, and this is kind of what I did the other day, and quite frankly, if I were to have submitted this as an assignment for grade, I probably wouldn't be very proud of myself, because to me, this doesn't really look finished. But the point is, I want to give kind of a feel for, this was kind of a little 5-minute brainstorming session. I can tell I didn't put a lot of time into it. I'm going to go back in here and kind of play a little bit with some of the ideas. So what I have here is something, and to me, this sketch kind of looks like almost a person's body and with arms, and I'm feeling some things happening, and this is where inspiration comes from. So I'm just going to kind of play with what I have here and work on some ideas. Now, for one of the ideas that I have here is to incorporate some really beautiful patterns and some colors, and I'm going to kind of make this into kind of a body. And there's going to be kind of like a tree goddess or something kind of back here. I don't know what it's going to look like when it's done. And the part that's super fun about art like this is that just because I have started it and this is the phase it's in, doesn't mean that's where it's going to end up. And when I get done with this, I think I am going to be surprised at what it looks like. So one of the things that I have going for me is that I have a ton of art materials that I can play with. And so what I know about myself is that I have the option to go in here and I can go over some of these lines with a material called gesso, which is a white paint that you can paint over. You could literally just whitewash the whole thing and paint over it. So I kind of have a dress and I have some arms and I have some things flailing around, and I'm going to have the person kind of go around and over it. Okay, so this is kind of where I'm starting. Now, just as a reminder, you know, I have this identity map project. So if you wanted to keep it more of a visual map, that's fine. If you want to keep it like this and just have little branches and little pictures, I kind of have little branches and little pictures, but I wanted to take it to the next level and I want to turn it into something kind of like this. So I know this looks nothing like that right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do some video of me just working, and I'm going to speed it up and we'll see what I end up with. So right now I'm just going to kind of put it on a pause, and then I'm going to turn around, get some paints out, and just kind of play and see what I can make. Okay.
All right, I just went out and I grabbed some materials, and as I was doing that, I thought, I should tell them a little more about what I'm doing. These are just paint cups that I've had. I use, they're not really clean because the paint's stuck, but it's not going to be a big deal, because I'm not being really picky. And I decided, I wanted to just show you, this is a paint sample, 50 cents from the Home Depot. Sometimes I just grab these because who knows what color you might use someday. And so these are kind of some weird green colors. I also grabbed a pile, I had this around, these are just scraps from other art projects that I had done, or I was going to throw them out. Things like that just are pieces of paper. So you can do collage on here. There's no rule about what you have to do and have to not do. This is called a matte varnish. So one of the things that's cool about this is once you get your stuff down, you can actually paint this on top of it. It's just like a clear glue. It's a varnish. Matte means that it's not shiny, it's flat. So I don't need this yet, so I'm not going to waste my time on that. I'm just going to get started. And I've grabbed some paints, and I basically have acrylic paint. These are matte acrylics. This is from a line, an artist that I love called Jane Davenport. And she's got some fabulous tutorials, things like that online, things that I love to watch. And I am such a sloppy painter. I like that about myself, but you don't have to be this way. A lot of times I'm in class and kids are like surprised about how much I run around and just squirt things and spray and, you know. So I'm just going to take a little bit of this color because I really don't know where I'm going with it quite yet. You can see I've kind of sketched out a face. So I'm going to go over this area, and you can see I'm going right over my lines. So you can't really, you can kind of see through it, but not much. And I'm kind of let this be the basis for kind of where I'm going to go. And I'm being very, very loose. And as you start to learn, what I'm doing right now is really intuitive art. It's nothing, nothing's perfect, nothing's forever, nothing's, I have to stay that way at all. And I'm going to paint over my name and then kind of let the roots grow down from here, okay? So I'm just kind of putting a base down. Now, the cool part about this paint, and you can see I'm drawing a body, but not well. What you see in this paint is it's kind of opaque, meaning not see-through. If I wanted to thin it out, I could put water in there, but I'm going to leave it kind of like this and let it dry. And the other part that I love about it is that it's a flat paint, matte paint. So I can draw on top of it. It's going to take another media really well. The other part that you're going to want to see if you have a glossy paint, it's going to not be as good if you're going to try to paint or draw over it later. So this is going to be something we call a mixed media piece. And when I have mixed media, that just means there's a whole bunch of different medias. So what do you do with a brush like this when you're done? Well, I'm not going to be done with it, but I'm going to put it down. And if I just lay it down like this, if this dries on it, thumbs down. So I just put it in my cup. A lot of art teachers or artists don't want their brush to sit further than this little part right here that's called the Furel. I think I said that wrong. this is glued onto there, and if it gets wet and it stays wet, you're going to have a bit of a problem. It'll start separating, the wood will expand, and you'll ruin your brush. So generally, you just want to really wash this off, and you can see acrylic paint doesn't come off very well. I'll just let it sit in there because I'm still using it. This cup also is going to dry out. When it dries totally, you can kind of peel it off usually in one fell swoop.